dear students, myself Ganga Bhosle, your statistic teacher. Today we are going to learn type 1 and type 2 error in hypothesis testing. In this diagram shows that when the null hypothesis is true and the conclusion is failing, to reject the null hypothesis is a correct decision. And when the null hypothesis is not true and it has rejected is also a correct decision. Okay? Now, null hypothesis is true and it has rejected, then it is termed as type 1 error. Whereas, when the null hypothesis is not true and it has failed to reject, then it has termed as type 2 error. When the researcher always decides to test the hypothesis either at 1%, 5% or 10% level of significance, it means that when he is deciding to test the hypothesis at 1% level of significance, it means that there is 99% confidence that the decision taken regarding the null hypothesis is right. When researcher is rejecting the null hypothesis at 1% level of significance, it means that there is 1% possibility that the null hypothesis is true and we are rejecting it. Okay? Now, this is our hypothesis testing. First one is one sample t-test, then independent sample t-test, after this paired t-test, f-test, chi-square test, goodness of fit. Chi-square test as a test of independence. Now, first one sample t-test. One sample t-test is a parametric test. And their uses are, first, when the data of one variable only and the data is collecting using interval and ratio scale. Second, size of sample space is small. And for one sample t-test, degrees of freedom is n minus 1. And the formula for one sample t-test is t is equal to x bar minus mu divided by standard deviation divided by under root n, where x bar is our sample mean, mu is our population mean, and standard deviation divided by under root n is standard error, that is SE. Now we solve example. An average electricity bill of a sample house is expected to be as rupees 450 per month. The electricity bill of 12 months amount to be as follows. Using 0.05% of level of significance, conclude whether the electricity bill is within a expected limits. There are 12 months given and their respective electricity bill, that is for month January there is rupees 490, for the month February electricity bill is 490, and up to December their electricity bill is 480. And here we have to calculate sample T, that is the value of T. First we write down given things, that is small n is equal to 12, given n is equal to 12, and there is also given that mu is equal to 450. Here null hypothesis, that is mu is equal to 450. since it is expected and the alternative hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis is Here our null hypothesis is mu is equal to 450. So automatically alternative hypothesis becomes mu is not equal to 450. It means that it could be more or less than rupees 450 per month. That is, either mu is greater than 450, greater than or equal to 450, or mu is less than or equal to 450. Mu is greater than or equal to 450, or mu is less than or equal to 450. Then we have to calculate T. And what is the formula for T? That is x bar minus mu divided by standard deviation divided by under root n. Here mu is 450, but we have to calculate x bar, standard deviation and standard error, that is standard deviation divided by under root n. For this we have to first calculate x bar. So for x bar, for calculating x bar, we have to add the values 490 up to 480 divided by n, that is 12. Here x bar is equal to 5780, that is the sum of 490 up to 480 is 5780, and the value of n is 12. So here we get 5780 divided by 12, and when we divide 5780 by 12, we get 481.67. Okay, then for this calculating, first we construct a table, that is the value of x, 490 up to 480, then we have to calculate x minus x bar, that is for this 490 minus x bar, the value of x bar is 481.67, which is equal to 8.34, and the value of x minus x bar bracket square means 8.34 is square, and the square of 8.34 is 69.556. Calculating all these values, I have already calculated. Then here in last column, sorry, in last row, we write sum of x, that is 5780. Then sum of x minus x bar bracket square is 21366.668. Okay, then we calculate standard deviation, which is equal to under root summation x minus x bar bracket square divided by n minus 1, which is equal to under root the value of summation x minus x bar bracket square is 21366.668, and the value of n is 12, 12 minus 1, which is equal to 11, which is equal to under root 1942.4243, and the square root value of 1942.4243 is 44.0729. Then we calculate standard error, which is equal to standard deviation divided by under root n. The standard deviation is 44.0729 divided by under root 12, n is 12. So here we write under root 12. When we divide 44.0729 by under root 12, we get 12.72. Then t is equal to, we know the formula for t is x bar minus mu divided by standard error, which is equal to the value of x bar. What is the value of x bar? Here 481.67 minus mu is 450 divided by standard error, that is 12.72. When we subtract 481.67 minus 450, we get 31.67 divided by 12.72, which is equal to 2.4889. This is our calculated value. Calculated value of t is 2.4889. Then we have to calculate tabulated value for degrees of freedom 11. Here n is 12 and degrees of freedom, that is n minus 1, which is equal to 11. This is our tabulated, tabulated t-test table, and in this we have to calculate for 11 degrees of freedom at 5% level of significance, that is 0.05, where in this table first we have to find out df, that is degrees of freedom. Here is 11 and 0.05, then 0.05, that is here 2.201. Tabulated value of t at 11 degrees of freedom at 5% level of significance is 2.201. So here table value is 2.201 and calculated value is 2.4889. Since the calculated value is more than table value, so the null hypothesis is rejected. Here we reject our null hypothesis. Calculated value. Here our calculated value is more than the table value. The null hypothesis is rejected, and since our null hypothesis is rejected, so we accept our alternative hypothesis, that is the electricity bill is not equal to rupees 450. Again, we need to decide if the bill is not equal to ₹450, then it is more than or less than ₹450. Okay, so it decides this, we need to take into consideration the sign of calculated value of T, which is positive in this case, which signifies that the electricity bill amount is significantly more compared to expected bill. Hence, the alternative hypothesis, that is mu is greater than or equal to 450, is accepted. Okay. I hope all of you understood this example. Thank you.